staff are reminded that you may be fired at any time. Thank you.
Sir Nigel Bickleworth on Two Point Radio. I hear that another university has opened its doors to the aspiring bookworms and lab rats of Two Point County. Listeners may remember that I don't like new universities because they're not old and therefore not any good. If they were, they'd have opened a long time ago. That's called logic, students, though I don't suppose you'd know.
Visitors should be checked in and then removed immediately. we're sorry for the litter that you... Oh, sorry, that's mine.
Welcome back. I can't say that I understand our county's recent fascination with opening pop-up universities on a weekly basis, but it seems appropriate to commemorate the opening of yet another fun-time house of real good learning. I thought we'd talk about the past, memories, and nostalgia. The feelings that things used to be in some incalculable and all-encompassing sense better. But why do we feel that way? Are we wearing rose-tinted glasses? Perhaps. Did everything used to be better? Probably.
If you hear this, please drink some water. Thank you. Someone that cares. Reminded to be constantly upbeat.
I used to love taking the train, the steam, the crisp sandwiches, watching people's luggage fall. Oh, those were the days. Sadly, I now find the experience of using our county's rail services is missing one rather vital component. I find that everyone seems all too engrossed by their mobile phones. Now, I have no interest in talking to anyone, but what I did like
was ignoring people. It's just no fun if they do it for you.
End of year is approaching. It's too late to start trying.
At Milkmaid, we use real dairy-style ingredients in our milkshakes for a level of consistency that just isn't natural. Meaning that every glass of Milkmaid is eerily similar to the last.
Wow!
Mmm, Milkmaid. Now that's good milk. Not technically milk.
Now I've forgotten. Pencils down. Only kidding. Thank you. started The Dogs Don't Eat Homework. Skills are not transferable.
Was recently stolen back to the days of my youth. Yes, after inadvertently trapping myself in the airing cupboard, what did I come across but my old wooden tennis clogs? It had been too long since I thought about my days on the university tennis team. It was said that the mere sound of our carved shoes were enough to cause eruptions of rosy cheeks and giggling on campus, although some believe that it had something to do with our shorts.
There's a fly in here. CB, it didn't happen. Not to me. Staff are reminded to care about students.
Whatever happened to wooden tennis shoes anyway? The visual spectacle of tennis used to be accompanied by a positive symphony, a sound like a company of coconuts dancing on a ballroom floor. Only wooden tennis clogs can produce such an enchanting auditory experience. But what do they wear now? Ghastly, squeaky things. And for what? Added grip? Light weight? It's practically cheating.
Announcement. Cheating is the wrong kind of clever. Sandwiches will be eaten by me. Students are asked not to ask questions. Are reminded to apologize to the janitorial staff. I'm sure you've done something.
The rise of the synthetic shoe is not confined to the tennis court, sadly. I'm sure many long-time listeners know that I visit Confetto's Cobblers once a year and treat myself to a pair of brogues, or loafers if I'm feeling scandalous. On my most recent visit, however, I was horrified to find that my dear cobbler had been replaced with an establishment by the name of the Shoe Zoo. But can one truly describe their collection of footwear as a menagerie without possessing a single pair of brogues? I think not.
If you don't know where your class is it really worth going?
Thank you.
students are reminded that some grades are personal. Hitting the books doesn't mean what you think it means.
Remember the start of the show? Remember when we were going to talk about nostalgia? Oh, what a paradise it seems. And yet, here we stand, talking about training shoes. Another vision gone awry over the savage passing of time. How fitting. How dreadfully sad. Things used to be better, dear listeners. How can you know for sure? Well, my show is over. They can't be getting better, can they?
Students are reminded to be nice to each other. If you aren't, who else will? Asked questions. No, I've not seen your frog. Are reminded that school spirit is infectious. Go us! students are reminded that I'm not your mum. Announcement. Plants need water, remember? Milkshakes are not an appropriate breakfast.
Whether you're just getting up or just getting in, it's sure to be difficult. I'm Felicity Bellbottoms and you're listening to Campus Radio, where we try and make whatever you're doing a little bit easier and a little bit noisier.
Students are reminded that there's no such thing as free time. Questions. No, I wasn't listening.
student protests continued to rage in the music college at Mitton today. Asked for their thoughts, feelings or demands, one student had this to say. I don't know really. Someone told me we're waiting to see an enormous bassoon. Is that not right? More on that curious bassoon later in the show. It's time for a review of the most popular cartoon on campus. Yes, that's right, the Bureaucats. This week, I'm reviewing the Bureaucats. Yesterday, Mittens, the cat, found an outrageously obscure bylaw just in time to delay a civil case another 10 weeks. Now, I don't understand the justice system at all, but I do understand drama, and those cats have it. Five cat paws out of a possible five.
It doesn't matter how desperate you are, no urinating on campus facilities. Noticed. questions? Yes. Classes are technically optional, and so is failing. The end of year results have been released. Luck won't help you now. The academic year is over. Students must vacate the campus.
Guys, hear me out. What if we went back to school?
It started as a class reunion and ended with them back in class.
That's crazy! Hey, I'm climbing on a statue. Whoa. Everybody, get in the shed! I can't revise anymore. My knees hurt.
Roderick Cushion is varsity freshman in Immature Students.
Students are reminded to set reminders. Questions. You can find the bathroom yourself. I believe in you.
Mm-hmm.
so stupid.